Hi everybody, it's Sam here and today I'm launching my new swing collection. Some of you might be familiar with this style, I have shared it before on my channel, but now I've got some dies that will create it for you and it will allow anything to swing in the middle of the card. So I've got these lovely little animals that I'm going to show you today. So here's a little chimp or monkey just swinging in at the center there. Get these lovely flowers, all of the leaves, the aperture to cut it, the papers in the background. Any top folding card this mechanism will work on. So there's this easel style one here that I've made. This is Katie the koala just swinging there. So cute. I love the pretty flowers on that one. You get the little gecko there as well and that lovely wood grain embossing folder. There's also George the orangutan. Love this one here. Go bananas. You can have a circle aperture if you want. You can see the flowers there and I've got some sequins. So these are all tent fold cards and this piece here folds up inside so it will fold flat. And then I'll show you one more sample. And this is this lovely toucan. And the sentiment says there, just a toucan of my appreciation. Again, you can see him swinging there. And there's another embossing folder in the background. So I'm going to be live at 12:30 today on the Craft Stash Facebook page. That will also be streamed onto Craft World and also onto their YouTube channel. I will be doing live demos showing you how to put these cards together. We'll also have some giveaways there as well. And to celebrate, you can receive a free paper pad with any £35 or over spend on the new swing collection and also 20% off selected Made to Surprise product. And I'll share all those direct links in the description box below this video. So I'm going to flip the camera around now. I'm going to show you the collection in more detail and the other samples that I've made. So this is everything in the new swing collection. So this is the die that will make the tent fold and the swinging part. So you've got the pieces here and then this is the base and then you've got your different apertures. If you have my double slider dies, these ones here, these are the additions. So you've got the square, which has got the woodland scene, and then you've got the circle one there. These will also work with this collection and vice versa. So this aperture will work well with this as well. So I try to, you know, make sure that when I release something, it's going to work with something from a past collection. Then you've got your main stamps here. These are so much fun. So you've got your Just Hanging Around, which has your orangutan, the sloth. You've got the snake there and also the cheetah. And you've got really fun puns, Just Hanging Around to Say Hi, Slow Down, It's Your Birthday, Happy Retirement. You've got your little signpost here and you can pop Go Wild in there, Go Bananas. You've got Sending Big Hugs. So there's some really nice ones there for many occasions. And then you've got Just Chilling. You've got the chimp or the monkey there. Really sweet. He's lovely to colour in. You've got your toucan, or you can colour it and, you know, it can be other birds as well. You've got your little gecko and then you've got your koala there as well. Another sign, so the hang in there will fit perfectly. The toucan do it fits in there. Party animal as well. And you've got spread your wings. I hope your birthday is quality. I'm wild about you. Party animal. Just a toucan of my appreciation and have a wild birthday. So that is your A5 stamp sets. You also get your dies to cut out the animals there as well. You can buy these in bundles. And then you have your tropical leaves and flowers. So you've got, I love this one because it die cuts two pieces. So it will die cut the inside and then obviously that outer frame. So you can swap over the center. So you can make some really nice looking flowers. This one I love. This is really nice to paper piece. You've got these ones here. You've got holes in the middle so you can pop stamens through them. And again, you can paper piece the middle here. This makes a really nice hibiscus. Layer these ones up. So there's some really nice styles that you can create. And you've got your center there as well. Then you have the tropical leaves. You've got your palm leaf there. Other nice big leaves there to use. And you've got some hanging vines as well. Then you've got the two embossing folders. I love these. These are probably up there as my favourites. This one in particular, which is the wood slice. And I've got an example here. You can see that lovely effect that you get. And that's just inked with a light brown. And then I rubbed a darker brown over the top. And then you've got your leafy background. I know I've spelt the end of this wrong. I made this very late at night before I launched on TV. And it was picked up on the TV. It was quite funny, but we'll forget about that. It's leafy background. But you can see here that lovely depth that you get when you add your different inks to the design there. It's really lovely. So they're both 6x6. And then finishing with the 6x6 scenes paper pad. So again, if you've got the woodland scenes paper pad, you'll be able to mix those together. They look really nice. And you get six designs and there's four of each. So you have this one here. Love the pops of the pink against that really lush green colour. This one's one of my favourites. I just love those trees. You have this one here again, those lovely flowers.
another one there, so you can have the obviously different animals hanging from the trees. And you have this one, and then you have this one, and then it's back to the beginning again. So that's a look at everything there. Now I'm going to show you some samples close up. So I've got quite a few here. Some of these are the ones that I made on TV. Now it's going to be hard for me to show you it's swinging because I've got to turn it up on its side, but this one here is one of my favourite ones. I've also added acetate to the front there, but he does move really freely. You can see there, and this one says just hanging around to say hi. And then on the back, you will have your space to write your message. These were all my samples, so I haven't done the backs on any of them, but I will do, and then they'll be ready to send out to people. But you can see all these lovely flowers. So there's the one I said about, you know, changing the centers. I've used some of my flatback pearls in the middle there, and just all different shades of green, and just build it up. It looks really nice. I've added the little snake here nestled amongst all the leaves and the flowers, and you can see there I popped a couple of stamens through the center. So that's one idea. And then I've got this one here, so you can see with that one, that's cutting the decorative aperture. You can just see parts of it there. This one I've just used the large circle, kept it very, very simple. This one's just sending you big hugs. Again, you can see where I've used the different flowers there. I've added some sequins, and again, you can see how nicely he will swing when it's all open. This is the tent fold part, so if you don't want to cut an aperture into this, you just want it as a tent fold, you can have some nice decorative paper on the front, or just stamp the images and just build up a nice scene. It's entirely up to you. And again, obviously all the space on the back, but you can see the different background papers there. And this is a 6x6 card, the papers are 6x6, so you're not having any wastage either. Then we've got this one, just a token of my appreciation. And there's that one where I said about paper piecing and building it all up. So really nice die, one of my favourites. And I just match the colours with the paper there. Easy to colour in as well. I use my coloured pencils with these. And I've also used acetate on all of the hanging pieces. So they really do look like they're swinging. But if you don't have acetate, you can die cut that using, you know, a green card, for example, and just stick more things attached to it, so you don't see it. And I've used on the back there, I've used the embossing folder and inked that up a little bit. This is just a different example. So anything that has a top fold, you can add the mechanism to. So this one is a easel card, and I've used the koala. Again, you can see she swings really nicely. And I've used the wood slice embossing folder, and then the excess that I cut out with the smaller circle frame, I've used as my stopper on the bottom here. So there's no waste on this card. And you can see the background there. This one's Have a Wild Birthday, and I've used gold and mirrored card. And then with this one, you could have your message, you could write your message here if you want, but you've got all the space on the back there. And this one just folds like so in the envelope, you can see there. These will fit into a standard envelope, but you may want to use a box envelope. I'll link my box envelopes up here if anybody would like to see those ones. And you've got the orangutan here. I've just got Go Bananas. Again, he does swing. They've all got a really, really lovely swing to them. And just some more of that detail. Need to flatten some of these because they've traveled. This one I like, this one I'm using the mirrored card, just hanging around to say hi. So that's the decorative aperture, and then I've just added the leaves behind and then just done a little kind of cluster at the top there. I like that one a lot. I've got another one here with the koala, just using the circles. I've got one of the vines hanging down, that lovely pink, and then you can see the way I've inked the background there, just slightly different. So I used a very, very light green and then a darker green. I used the actual pad and just brushed it over the top. So that's another, I think this was one that I made as a demo actually. Another monkey one there. So you can see there's no acetate on the front of this one, so you can see them probably a bit easier. I'm Wild About You. And then just showing you other folds. So this one here is a box card. So you would have seen these on my channel before. I've done some spinning Christmas versions, but this one here, you can see he swings at the front there. And you can see the style of that. And then I've used the embossing folder in the back. And then you've got your space there to write your messages. That's another orangutan one there with a different pattern paper. Then I've done this crisscross one. Spread your wings. It just seemed to work really well with this style. And again, I've used that wood slice on the front. So just giving you other ways to, you don't have to use any of the swing part. You can just use the flowers and the embossing folders. And then I've got this one here, which is the bay window card. I've just used the pattern paper. I put googly eyes on the snake there. It looks really cool. And this one just clips in there and then it says hang in there. So you can write your message inside that part. I have the bay window cards on my channel, so I'll link those for you. Again, just the stamen detail there. And then I've got this one, which is like the wreath style that I've shared on my channel, but this time I've got him swinging from the top there. Again, it does swing really nice. It's just hard to show this style from my camera view. Slow down, it's your birthday. And I've just popped a little stopper in there. But if you want to see how to make that style card, just check out my wreath cards. And then this one here is the swing fold, which I thought worked well again with the swing collection. I've just stamped the monkey there onto a circle, built up this little scene. And then this one, you can see how that swings around when it's open. Have a wild birthday, stamp the little gecko there, and I've used the embossing folder throughout. So you've got your space there to write your message. Again, 6x6, all folds nice into an envelope. Again, got this one on my channel, so you'll be able to see how to make that. And then just something really simple and really clean. And this is using the center of this piece is this here. So again, you know, don't throw those pieces away. They're really nice to use on more simple cards. This one took no time at all, just a token of my appreciation. Maybe you just like the stamps and the embossing folders, and you can make these lovely cards as well. So I hope you enjoyed this closer look at my latest release. As I said at the beginning, I'm going to be live today over on the Craft Stash Facebook page and also over on Craft World. And I'll link those links in the description box below. And I'll also link all of this product so you can go and take another look if you want to. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back again very soon with fun tutorials using this product.